where we have to be getting close to discovering out the truth behind where our sister Sam and our parents went. Where could they have gone? We're getting close. So let's dive right in. Inside this spooky hidden passageway, and yes, if you watched the very end of the last episode, I got scared because the light it burned out, it popped, and it went dark as soon as I picked crucifix, and that scared me and was also hilarious. We also found this note from Sam where they identified three separate hidden compartments found around the house that look just like this. They have a photo attached in the baseboards. You can actually take them out. So there's one in the opposite corner of the library, which is where the secret passage leads to. There's one in the foyer. Foyer sounds, I don't know, I just like it. There's one upstairs across the entrance from Sam's room. The other entrance next to that bathroom up there. So in this episode, we are going to find Foyer's in those secret compartments and see where that will lead us. Ready for a Ghost Hunters House Investigation special episode, because that's what this one is. We're going to look for ghosts. Let's do this. I mean, this special compartment or secret hallway is creepy enough. You can't see now, but on the wall, just a bunch of and was in fact very creepy. So, if you recall this hidden compartment, it led into our parents' room, or it started in our parents' room, their closet. And when closed, you can't even tell it was there. A show flyer that says the Misfits. us a special guest, Maidenhead, at the Stygia 306 West Franklin Street. So, from a previous episode, that was the same show. That's also when she lied to her parents about where she was going. We don't know what she told the parents, but she definitely did not say she was going to a concert. So she went to the concert with Lonnie and had a great time at her first concert, and she loved it. And loved being there with her friend Lonnie. So this looks like a more official, flyer. The Misfits, and again, that's MISS-Fits, and Maidenhead. So this sounds like very feministic bands, which I'm sure that they love. That's awesome.
At Todd's brother's place after the show, there was only a futon to sleep on, so Lonnie and I shared it. The lights went out. I was turned toward her. My eyes started to adjust, and then I could see she was looking at me, too. In the dark, she smiled. My heart was beating so fast. I rolled over. I felt so, I don't know, nervous? After a minute, she put her arm around me and was so close and whispered in my ear, "I really like you." I just nodded my head and I really hope she could tell. I really hope that she meant what I think she did. I felt like a shook-up can of soda ever since. I hope we have the chance to talk before I explode.
So after she lied to her parents and went to this concert, I wonder what lies she would work that would allow her to even spend the night somewhere else. But laying on the bed with Lonnie likes her as a friend. She's our sister. And I'm happy if she's happy. But I'm also kind of disappointed that there isn't an actual ghost in this hidden compartment. I was hoping, I guess the mascot person is pretty scary. That could count as a ghost. One second. Sam was saying that she hopes she gets a chance to talk to us before she leaves, or before something happens. Was she afraid that she wouldn't see us again? Or are we going to see her sister again? I hope. is October 29th. We look at our inventory. Our flight back from Amsterdam to Portland was June 6th. So that was actually a pretty long time ago. October 29th, that was like 8 months ago then, wasn't it? If it's June now, and that's something like that, something like 8 months. So, that's interesting. So, but what has happened in the 8 months since? Surely some things had to happen. She couldn't have been gone for the past 8 months, right? It sounds like she just left. Because she was able to write the note to put under the guest door, telling us that because we came home on such short notice, the parents were able to put together the guest bedroom. So she had to be here. And the red lights are on in the attic. The attic is locked, so she could actually still be in the attic. We still have more investigation to do. Let's find those other compartments. So the other one was somewhere over here, I think. Yes. Back in the foyer. Says 50-1. It says right three times, stop at, then full turn, passing first, then at second number, then second stop at third number, and then at, and written in like a pin at the bottom, it says something of Sam, property of Sam, private. So this is something we need the other half of this to really understand what this is, because I'm stuffed right now. I'm really not sure what this is. Interesting, it's a Sam's locker combo added to backpack. Oh, okay. So that's her locker number. Okay, 50-1. So we don't know the first number yet. Sam's room, there was her locker. I think we tried to fiddle with it, but we definitely did not know the combination. Okay, so else in this little compartment, it's a story called Heaven at the Edge of the World. The Green Glacier Part 2 by Samantha Greenbrier, 9th grade, 12/1/92. And written on it in marker, it says private, do not read. So of course, we're going to read this. So this is another entry into her Captain Allegra sprawling story here. If I recall, very early on, she wanted to find the edge of the world. Let's go ahead and read this Allegra story. Shouted, "Stop!" She saw the Queen Amazonian up on her pedestal, reaching for the lever that would drop her first mate into the vat below. She shouted, "No!" She threw her saber at the Amazon's reach, but it was too late. The first mate screamed as he fell into the water and splashed down. Just like the first mates. she liked to first me for who he was, and even when that happened, it doesn't matter, it's still the same person. That's the love of my life, and you can't have her. Foreshadowing. That's, you know, fairly decent writing for sure. She probably takes after her dad. And she wrote in private, do not read on the front. You know, because this is, it's like her diary, her journal, but in fictional form. This is how she's thinking. This is what she wants. So let's just put that back and close this panel here. So there is one panel left. As the thoughts and ideas of Sam are kind of coming together, there's still this door over here on the right side, and that door is still locked. But let's be back in the grand entrance of this mansion and walk up these big wooden stairs under this bright chandelier and go explore the last Sam's room, and we're still missing the rest of the combination at this time to open her locker, but maybe we'll find our answers in this last compartment. So, I found the last compartment. It's right outside Sam's second door and right next to the bathroom. So, yeah, this is definitely the other half of the combination to open her locker. But the question is, who was she hiding this stuff for? Was she hiding it for us to find? Inside. So we have, yeah, the complete combination now. It's 0, 50, 1. says to open, turn right three times, stop at first number, turn left one number, now turn left one full turn, passing first number, to stop at second number, turn right and stop at third number, Paul Shackle, the property of Sam. She even get a locker, honestly. That's interesting. Okay, so what else? In this secret compartment, there is a Ouija board. One of those old-fashioned Ouija boards. And if you don't know what that is, that's kind of the, say it is how you connect with ghosts and spirits of the house. So there is a board that has every letter of the alphabet as well as every number. It also has the options yes, no, and goodbye. And supposedly you can call it, and every person there puts their hands, their fingers on the disc, and supposedly you talk to the ghost, and if they're, you know, feeling up to it, they will answer your question by moving the disc slowly to each letter to spell something out in order to connect with you. The weather actually works and you are talking to ghosts or that one person or more just wants to, you know, whether intentionally or not, spell certain things out. That is not really, but debatable. So the old style wooden Ouija board has a sun with a face on it in the top left, a moon with a face in the top right, and a skull with a crown on it. It's kind of creepy looking. The bottom jaw is missing. In the middle is a pretty creepy Ouija board. So along with the Ouija board, there is a pen and a blank piece of paper with some writing on it. And what it looks like is the questions that they it. It responded, exactly what he did. He was just confined to the house. Never really left. People probably made up a bunch of stories about this house. So that means the ghost of Oscar is talking to them. Then they ask their third question. Just the letters B-A to come back, and then the letter, the writing on the A is it's like the last line on the A is elongated and stretched out farther, as if what I'm assuming is that Lonnie and Sam were writing this and wrote Sam's locker. So let's see what she has in her locker. The code was 0501. And there we have it. So we just open up her locker. And on the right side a photo of Lonnie.
Lonnie came over today, but everything was different. She was sitting at my desk chair, and she wouldn't look at me. Finally, I asked her what was going on. She said she felt like she'd done something wrong that night in the city. Like I must think... But I said no. There was nothing wrong. I just wanted to say... But I couldn't find the words. I felt like I was gonna cry, but I wasn't sad. She got up and sat next to me on the bed. I looked at her. Lonnie, do you think you could ever... And that's when she kissed me.
is on the inside door of her locker. Next to it is a basement key. Now, which one was that? There was a few locked doors. There was the attic. And then downstairs there was... Oh, that one's still locked. Oh, yes. And then on the hallway to the left at the very end. That's right. There was a doorway over there. So now we can explore the basement. Now, why was that key locked up in Sam's room? Like, were the parents never able to go to the basement? Because she stole. Security tags. Apparently they're still on them right there. This green shirt and this blue long sleeve shirt. The tags are still right on it. something that you may not want to see. You may want to close your eyes, right? It's something that, it's half hidden, so I can't tell what's on it, but I may not be able to show it here. Let's find out. Okay. So it's not that bad, but it's the magazine for men. Gentlemen. Called Gentlemen. With the taglines of special. Exclusive interview with mogul David Kevin. Finally, Jillian Anderson. The magazine for men. So, Sam probably stole that from her dad, Terry. Because we know Terry was looking at some of that stuff too. So both of the parents were kind of a little crazy, but so we just closed the locker, and I think we viewed everything we can. So downstairs, the front porch, the foyer, TV room, Dad's office, the library, the music room. If we go up, Sam's room. Mom and Dad's room, the bathroom, guest room, sitting room, sewing room, and the hidden door to the attic, but the attic is locked. So, we did just get the key to the basement. So, that has to be our next stop, because we viewed every room that we can. Outside, as it has been this night. hearts were so open and accepting. This is just something that's just so personal, so deep that I can understand why Sam would not want to have anybody know. So we kind of know what happened in the past, but we don't know why she's gone right now. It sounds like she'd left and a few things were missing. She started saying the attic, but crossed it out and threw it away. So there's something about the attic, which for right now it's locked, but there is something about the attic. I'm sure we'll figure that out later. Tell Mom and Dad sorry. Tell Mom and Dad what we found. The basement awaits. I put in the key, unlock the door to the basement. I take a step inside and look down the dark hallway. I stand here at the top of the stairs, looking down into the stairs to the basement, as I say. Thank you for watching this episode. Ooh, I know, right? You wanted to see what's down in the basement. But I guess we will see that next time on Gone Home. Thank you so much.